Hi, this is Manya Singh from Law School 101, and this is another video in the English series brought to you by Law School 101 for CLAT aspirants. Today, we will be covering pronouns, adjectives, adverbs, modals, and punctuation. In this video, we will navigate through a brief explanation on these topics and then work through all the related questions from the previous year's CLAT and ILEP papers of 2017, 2016, and 2015, wherever they have been asked. The order has been listed for convenient movement to required sections, and the answers will be marked with a green arrow. Before we begin, you may have noted that pronouns, adjectives, and adverbs have been dealt with in detail in an earlier video. In this video, however, a number of examples are discussed to familiarize you with them so that you can recognize them in an instant when the question pops up. Let's begin with the video. Pronouns. Pronouns are usually small words which stand in place of a noun, often to avoid repeating the noun. Pronouns are of the following type. Number 1. Indefinite pronouns include anything, anybody, anyone, something, somebody, someone, nothing, nobody, none, no one, etc. Personal pronouns are he, she, they, it, etc. Reflexive pronouns are myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, oneself, ourselves, yourself, themselves, etc. Demonstrative pronouns are this, that, these, those, etc. Possessive pronouns include mine, yours, his, hers, ours, theirs, etc. Relative pronouns are that, which, who, whose, whom, where, and when. Interrogative pronouns include who, what, why, where, when, whatever, etc. Reciprocal pronouns are each other and one another. The next topic is adjectives. Adjectives qualify nouns. The types of adjectives are as follows. Number 1. Possessive adjectives are my, his, her, its, ours, theirs, and yours. Demonstrative adjectives are this, that, those, and these. Number adjectives are 1, 2, 3, 100, etc. Interrogative adjectives are which, what, and whose. Indefinite adjectives are none, several, few, some, many, any, little, and a lot. Attributive adjectives are honest, beautiful, tall, lean, curvy, black, blonde, brown, etc. Next are adverbs. Adverbs describe a verb, adjective, or another adverb. Adverbs of time are immediately, before, afterwards, always, last month, last year, now, then, soon, already, yesterday, tomorrow, etc. Adverbs of place include above, below, here, there, outside, over there, inside, under, and upstairs. Adverbs of manner include quickly, slowly, merrily, happily, sadly, joyously, reluctantly, willingly, excitedly, and deftly. Adverbs of degree include nearly, really, so, almost, much, etc. Adverbs of degree are, as mentioned, adverbs of frequency are often, rarely, frequently, seldom, never again, almost, always, sometimes, ever, usually, normally, weekly, hardly ever, etc. Next are modals. Modals are words that give additional information about the verb. For example, they indicate possibility, necessity, order, request, chance, probability, advice, obligation, ability, willingness, prohibition, or permission. The list of main modals are given below. Generally, will expresses certainty, can expresses ability, could expresses possibility, may expresses chance, might expresses fewer chances, would expresses future certainty, shall, should, and must express varying degrees of obligation and ought expresses ideal actions. They perform other functions too. The last topic is punctuation. Punctuation is an essential part of any sentence. It forms the structural framework for sentences and words to make sense in relation to one another. Common punctuation marks are the full stop, used to demarcate the end of a sentence. The second is a comma. It is used for listing items or for embedding phrases. The third is the question mark. It is used to indicate that the sentence is a question. The fourth is the exclamation point. It is used to express strong or intense emotions such as surprise, shock, anger, exasperation, exhilaration, etc. The fifth is a colon. It is used to indicate the beginning of a list relating to the part preceding the colon. The sixth is a semicolon. It is used to express the related sentences that can stand as independent sentences. The seventh is quotation marks. It is used to indicate spoken dialogue. The eighth is the apostrophe. It is used to indicate possession and quality of ownership or used when words are abbreviated. The last are brackets. They are used to provide additional information to the reader. Now we will begin discussing questions from the previous year's paper. The first question is from class 2017. The question is, if they want to succeed, they dash work very hard. The correct answer is choice C. In this question, all options with the exception of B, that is ought, would be correct. However, the most appropriate choice is C, which is must. This is because it is a necessity and an absolute certainty that they need to work hard if they want to succeed. This necessity or certainty is best indicated by must. Now questions from CLAT 2016 will be discussed. There were quite a few in this paper. Question 1. There isn't dash water in the overhead tank. The correct option is B, any. No other option is grammatically correct. Question 2. They always give the available seats to dash comes first. The correct option is D, whoever. This question is a little tricky. The difference is whomever and whom are object pronouns. They would ideally replace him, her, etc. in a sentence. Who and whoever are subject pronouns. They would replace he, she, etc. in a sentence. In this case, we need a subject pronoun. You can determine whether to use a subject pronoun or an object pronoun by substituting he and him in the sentence. Clearly in this case, he would be used, which means a subject pronoun is required. Question 3. A fire broke dash in the neighborhood. This one is very straightforward. The answer is option B, out. Question 4. A thief does not dash the door. This is another simple question. The answer is option A. Question 5. There is a lot of work dash hand. Let's cancel dash picnic. The correct answer is C. As discussed in the previous video, make sure your double blanks allow the text to make sense together. In this case, if you figure out one blank, you can use it to eliminate the other options. For example, the second blank is definitely the. That leaves options A and C. However, upon hand does not make sense, so this option can also be eliminated. We are left with option C, which is the correct answer. Question 6. It's unfortunate he died dash cancer. This is a simple question. The correct answer is B. Now, we will discuss a final question from ILIT 2016. This question 1. You dash mad if you think I'm going to lend you any more money. This question is an easy application of the model concepts learned so far. The answer to this question is C, must be. Remember, in models, more than one answer may be correct, but the most appropriate has to be selected by considering the function of the model. In this video, no questions from CLAT 2015 and ILIT 2017 are discussed because there were none relating to this topic specifically. Thank you for watching this video. For more resources, follow, like, and share our page Law School 101 on Facebook. Also, subscribe to our main YouTube channel by the same name. We encourage you to post your doubts, queries, and questions in the comment section below. These will be replied to within reasonable time. Best of luck, law aspirants.